Hi, in this episode we are going to write a function that shows in the equipment bar our collected items. At the end of this video, the game will be very close to its final shape. For now, we have this function that lets us select the item we want to use in the game, but the game doesn't know how to show us those items we have collected so far. That's why in the game manager we will create a new public void update equipment canvas. Inside we will need to find out how many items we have and use this information in a loop in which we are going to change sprite of every item slot. And at the end we will add two special conditions related to how many items we have, but more about that later. In this function we will check every item slot and set its item sprite. We will know how many items we had collected, so for example this item slot number 0 will be set to a sprite from the collected items list only if we have at least one item. But if we have only one item, this item slot number 1 will be set to a default sprite. And we will do the same for the rest of item slots. Sounds simple, and I think it really is. Alright, let's go back to programming and start with finding out how many items we have collected. We'll create a new integer type variable and we'll name it itemsAmount. This will be set to collectedItemsList.count. Alright, with this data we know how many item slots from the beginning will have items inside and the rest will have just default sprites. But we also need to know when to stop the loop, so let's find out how many item slots do we have. To get this value we will need equipmentSlots.length. We use .length here because this is an array and collected items is a list. I think the for loop is a reasonable option here. We start from 0 and keep looping as long as the value of I is less than item slot amount, and every step we increment I. There we will just choose between using a default image and a sprite from collected items list. And as we said before, to achieve this we will use a if statement and check if this I variable is less than items amount. If it is, we will use equipment images with the I index dot sprite and set it to the sprite inside the collected items list under the I index dot item slot sprite. Every item we can collect in this game has a special sprite variable where we put a sprite to show in the equipment bar and we now just access it. The last thing we need in this loop is a behavior for I being the same or bigger than items amount. Then we will just set this sprite to items empty item slot sprite. Oh, that's the name, so let's change it in this comment too. Okay, and now it's time for special conditions. First, if we don't have any items, so the items amount is 0, we want to select item with minus 1 as an argument. You can't use a negative number as an index of an array or a list. This argument would break the game in this line, but we can just modify this if statement and hit return, so we won't do anything below that. So let's do this. Add a or here and let's just check if the equipment canvas ID is less than 0. And after doing that we should change this comment over there. Okay, and now we don't really need to care about what happens if we don't have a previously selected item, because this if statement protects us pretty well. Okay, our job here is done, so let's scroll down and add one more if statement over there. Copy those two lines, write an else statement and paste them. Now we want to check if items amount equals 1. And if it's true, we want to select this one item we have in our equipment. That's quite important, especially when the player picks up the first item in the gameplay. Because they will have a big yellowish square over there, they will know that something has changed in their equipment and they can use a new item after some kind of action. Now we just need to change the code in a few places to make those functions work properly. First we need to go to the Click Manager and find this debug.lag line. It's in the update scene after action I enumerator. Now instead of sending the message to our console, we want to finally use gamemanager.updateEquipmentCanvas. That way we will refresh our equipment every time we pick up a new item. The next thing we need to change is in tryGettingItem function, which is inside the Click Manager. For now we have this .contains, which checks if we have an item in our collected items list. But we will need to check if we have selected the item which is required. To do this we will need to access gameManager.selectedItem, but we can do this because it's not public. We can change it in no time. And now we can go back to the Click Manager and use gameManager.selectedItemID. We need to check if this ID is the same as item.requiredItemID. And that was the last line of code in this episode. In Unity we can see that our clickable objects, for example the plant, don't have item slot sprite. We will need to go to the spreadsheet to create one, but first let's check what else do we need. We need a big man, we also need a water on the table, but I think we've created one. Yep, we have, so let's use this one over there. And let's go to the spreadsheet and let's create a new box. Put it, for example, on this plant, and this will be our image for the plant in the equipment bar. The same goes to this bottle, and we will use it with the big man. Just make sure that you don't use the regular one, because you will see that it looks weird in the equipment bar. Okay, now let's go to the plant and let's do the same. And again, make sure that you click the correct sprite. And as it comes to the setter, he doesn't need anything because this is the last clickable object. And after we do that, we don't get any item, but instead we win the game. And as we are about to win the game, we will see a big white rectangle on this equipment bar. That's because we will put none as a sprite to this equipment bar. For now, please don't care about that. Instead, let's do something fun. I mean, programming is fun too, of course, but you know, something different. Finally, we can check out if this game is playable. We got this water bottle, it's selected, and as we click outside of its item slot, it's no more selected. And now we can go to the plant, we get a message because we didn't select the water bottle, we click again, and we see that we have this plant here. And we have an error, we shouldn't be allowed to do this. We have a water bottle selected, not the plant, so something is weird here. Oh, never mind, the big man's required item ID is still at -1. But if you set it to 1, which is plant's ID, everything will be working. We get this man's boost and we give it to the Santa, and that way we win the game. And with that positive message, we can end this episode. I could tell you that in the next episode we will have to fix some errors, but I won't, because that would break the mood. Have a good day and see you soon!